Welcome to the program. Is paper a conductive material?
No, paper is not conducting.
But nevertheless,
we can use, yes. In fact, we are using, we built the first transistor, paper transistor in the world, but we are using paper, cellulose paper, the conventional paper, not only as a substrate for depositing, for printing our devices, but we are using paper as an active electronic component. So we can exploit, for example, the insulator properties of paper to build integrated circuits.
What is a transistor?
A transistor is like a switch, is an on-off, like a switch.
Okay.
So
we use them in computers
you
and
use
chips
everywhere,
every time.
At this moment, we cannot survive
without transistors. So, and but they're working.
Yes,
so they what's are the problem?
The problem for what?
Because you're working on new transistors using paper.
Yes, but of course we don't want to compete, for example, with the traditional microelectronics industry or with the conventional material that is silicon. But for example, if you are looking for disposable things, for example, if you are looking for packaging for low costs or for products that are already using paper, we can incorporate in these packagings or in these labels electronic functionalities.
For example?
For example, you can put, for example, sensors in your packagings. You can add electronics, for example, for your pharmaceutical, for the medicaments.
Yeah.
You can add some functions just to see, for example, if you are taking the pills in the correct time or not. Because everything, you can have a lot of information in conventional packaging.
And
or you can track, for example, a package. If you are sending a package from here to Taiwan or to China, you can follow this precisely packaging.
Ah, okay, you can track it. You can track
the
parcel.
In an active way.
But I can do this with the conventional transistor technology as well.
Yes, of course, but the price that you are paying is much higher. And for example, for tracking each packaging that you are delivering today, you are not using this type of system because it's quite expensive.
And what is different in your transistor? You have to explain it a little bit. Where comes paper into play? Because
yes.
Someone, I think, well, transistor is an electronic part and it has to be conductive materials.
Yes, and some
And paper is not conductive. So where comes paper into play?
Okay, for making a transistor or another integrated circuit, you need to have three different materials. Insulators, like glass or paper. Conductors, like metals. And semiconductors, like silicon. And
semiconductor means?
Semiconductor is a material, is the king for the integrated circuits. You cannot have a transistor or having an integrated circuit without semiconductors. And the most used semiconductor is silicon.
And why is it, what does it mean, semiconductor?
A semi is because it's not an insulator or a conductor. The conductivity is between an insulator and a metal, for example. And you can control, you can modify the electrical properties of a semiconductor.
Okay.
For example, you cannot modify the electrical properties of a glass. Your electric cables are not made by glass. Also, a metal, you cannot decrease, you cannot turn on, for example, the conductivity of a metal to be an insulator. But with semiconductors, I can tune the electrical properties. That's why we are using semiconductors for making electronics.
Okay, three parts. And where's paper?
The three parts. Yeah. So we have a conductor, a semiconductor, and an insulator for making an integrated circuit or a transistor. In the case of paper, paper works like the insulator material. So we have the metals and the semiconductors, and the insulators in that case are the paper by itself. So we can use paper, cellulose paper, as a truly electronic material,
and
which is flexible,
very
light, it's biodegradable, we can recycle, so we have a lot of advantages.
It sounds convincing, but what what were the obstacles you had to overcome? I mean,
at this moment we don't have... Okay, this is completely new. We are also already working with some industries, mainly in in the Nordic because the forests are there, so we have a lot of industry paper in the Nordic, and we are working with that companies just to exploiting what are the properties of the materials and try to make paper that fits our needs for specific applications. And for example, we are inside several European projects with these companies also involved, just to see and to try to exploit this new type of technology.
You said your university has research contracts with huge electronics.
Yes, but in another field, not in the paper, because I'm here for two topics, paper electronics and transparent electronics. And in the case of transparent electronics, we are working with some companies in South Korea, like Samsung and also LG. In fact, we have a common patent with Samsung.
And transparent electronics means?
The electronics are completely transparent, so you can perform metals, you can deposit, or you can produce metals, insulators and semiconductors completely transparent. I will present this today.
How do you do it?
By using different materials, oxides. By using metal oxides like zinc oxide, indium oxide, oxides.
Okay, so...
Even materials that we are using for creams, for cosmetics, or even for sun creams, we are using the same materials but for making electronics.
Is it nanotechnology?
Also with nanotechnology, but here the point is new materials. We are working with materials that can be used as semiconductors and as metals. We have transparent metals, and there are already available some prototypes, a big, huge displays, completely transparent. So this is not anymore science fiction, it's reality.
So you have a display?
A display that is fully transparent. Imagine, you can have your GPS in the glass of your car. It's fully transparent, and when you switch on, you will see the maps.
And I could have a display
as a window. Yes, you have a window, but simultaneously the window is also a display, especially, for example, for marketing.
And is it ready to market?
Yes, yes, by sure.
And I can buy it already?
This is available for some smartphones, but they are not exploiting the transparency. Because besides these materials, they are transparent, but also the electrical performance are much better than the conventional ones. And for some applications, maybe transparency is not an added value. But for example, if you are looking for windows or for transparent things, you can incorporate these displays. But they are already some prototypes available. And for example, if you are going to Seoul, to Korea, inside the metro station, you can see all these huge screens for advertising. They are fully transparent.
Okay. And you came up with the idea?
Yes, I came with the idea. In fact, this work was, they start more or less simultaneously in three places. In the United States, Japan, and Portugal. But in Japan and at United States, they develop all these materials using high temperatures, for example, 900 degrees, 600 degrees centigrade. And we developed the same technology, but at room temperature. That's why this is compatible with plastics, with paper. And nowadays, everyone is using our technology at room temperature.
But how do you produce those materials? I mean, do you just melt one metal, metal?
No, by using physical techniques, by evaporation, some technological, or even by printing. We can have, for example, with the help of nanotechnology, for example, we can have nanoparticles, and we will develop some inks, and we will put these inks inside the cartridges of our inkjet, and we will print. This is also not science fiction. We have already some papers published. So we can formulate these inks, and you can print, or you can using the conventional microelectronic technologies for depositing these materials, like the ones that you have in your glasses, you have Pashur and anti-reflection coating. Mm-hmm. So I'm talking about the same materials, but besides being transparent, they are conducting.
But I mean, metals are not transparent.
No.
So how do you change this?
Because we can play, we can start with these oxides and we can dope. So this is like cooking. We can add some other elements to these materials and we can change dramatically the conductivity of the material. Yes.
Okay, what's next on your plate? I mean, what do you do?
Okay, now we are, besides the transparent electronics, also in the field of paper electronics, also we are working on biosensors. The idea is to try to democratize the diagnostic tests, yeah, especially for tuberculosis or even malaria, and to help persons that are living in other countries without all these resources that we have available here, and to try to develop the very easy and low cost, like pregnant tests, where we can see if we are in the presence of a positive or a negative.
So and also it's also cheaper as than the current ones.
Yes, because it's based on paper.
Okay, is 3D printing an interesting field for you?
For these applications, not really.
And even not for the transparent conducting materials, no.
No. This is more for 3D printing. Is more for biomaterials where you can mimetic or you can reproduce some dimensions. Not for that area. Here, okay. I'm talking about the thickness, for example, of a display, the materials that I'm talking about, the huge thickness, for example, just for you to have an idea, our hair, the dimension is around 50, 60 micrometers, which is 10 to minus 6 of a meter. And I'm talking about thicknesses, the materials that I'm using, some tens of nanometers. So we are, the quantity of material is... The material is less, the cost is quite low, and also the quantity of material is just some monolayers of.
And within these layers, you have all the conducting circuits.
Yes, we have.
And display means it's also emitting light, no?
Yes, of course, because the you have two categories of displays today. The based on LCDs, liquid crystals, and the new generation based on OLEDs, organic light emitting diodes. And for this new generation of displays, for example, the OLEDs, you don't need to use liquid crystals because liquid crystals, they don't emit light. They are black or white. And in order to have color in our screens, we need to have a lot of filters and a lot of things to have color. If you switch to this new technology, by emitting light, we will have the RGB, three LEDs that we will emit, and also you combine all these things to make the image, but they need to have high current. And the available technology do not support these high currents. The transistors, they are not able. Mm-hmm. They are not the good ones. So the ones that we developed using these transparent materials, they are much better because they can give high levels of current for these OLEDs, for this lighting.
And can I spray them on the wall?
We can spray, but if you have pixels, so when you spray in a continuous manner. Yeah. And for example, a display, you have billions of pixels, so if you are looking for a high resolution, and we need to deposit, we need to use microelectronics or inkjet, because if you spread like that, everything will be in short circuit, because you have a huge pixel, not millions of pixels, because they are discrete. Well, they are all connected, they are integrated, but they are discrete devices.
Thank you very much for your time.
You're
very
welcome.
Interesting.
Thank you very much.
Much.